not what you know, but who you know that knows it. You may be searching in the dark for years. Well, perhaps you need a key for the answers that you seek. You have to hunt for good ideas. It doesn't take an academic genius to think up the solution that you need. Listen to the conversation if you want an innovation, and anyone might sow that vital seed. It's not what you know, but who you know that knows it. Two heads are much better than just one. You must open up your mind, leave secrecy behind. Co-creation can be fun. And if you should run out of inspiration, and no one ever answers when you phone, when someone new appears, tell them all your good ideas. The company you keep may be your own. This new idea is better than old Joseph Schumpeter with his destructive creativity. Opportunities increase, we were told by David Deese, if we build dynamic capability. It's not what you know, but who you know that knows it. Astrologers might say it's in your stars. Well, it may be rather trite, but you just might see the light if you hang around in bars. Cheers! And in your search for radical solutions, be careful that you leave no stone unturned. Don't batten down your hatches, take a risk, play with matches, and don't complain if sometimes you get burned. If competitors are many, and you can't discover any whose products are less fashionable than yours, well, find yourself a mate, and then collaborate. You'll be the team the market just adores. And when your innovation is quite open, and all your sourcing's coming from the crowd, your pitch will be compelling, your products will be selling, and you can let yourself feel proud. Remember, innovation's never ending. You've got to brace yourself, take the strain. You must bend another ear with another new idea, and then you can collaborate again. You're a genius and it shows, but that's just the way it goes. It's not what you know, but who you know that knows. It's not what you know, but who you know that knows. It's not what you know, but who you know that knows.